Backseat Nightingale, right back where we started from. Well, it is almost time to say goodbye. Shall I not play this?
I know, it's too much.
Just kidding, let's play that. It's nearly time for our last handover with the wonderful Ken. Morning Show, playing some bangers this morning for the mighty Bruce's last day. We're going to miss him massively. Let's give him a good send-off, Lee, in a very sunny Falmouth. You've got to say, haven't you, he is such a hero of ours. He's been in our ears in the mornings with Tracks in My Ears and Popmaster When We All Stop. Also on many a Friday night is Music Night, and of course with Eurovision. He's not going to be doing Eurovision this year, no! For some of us, he's been on the radio and in our ears for over half or most of our lives. He's a class act. We know he's super smart. He's so supportive of everybody else here. He's been wonderful to me, I have to say. Thank you, Ken. He's self-deprecating, he's a true gent with razor-sharp wit, and is genuinely hilarious. I'm going to miss my radio neighbour hugely, and his chats with Jeremy, which are often hilarious. But we know he's going to have great adventures ahead. So Balearic Ken, King Ken, Popmaster, or the Bruce, as Jewel calls him, this is for you. This has come in from our listeners, Tom Carey from Cornwall and Ian Lillicrap. And it is called Simply Dear Ken.
Dear Ken, what a time we've seen. 31 years and still going. When listening to your voice has been sending us on a daydream. Dear Ken, when we've been starting our day, your voice has taken us away to happy ever after and so much laughter. Tested us with your Popmaster. Dear Ken, what a time we've had. 31 years, yeah, that ain't half bad. I brew it, Bruce, 25 past 10. Knowing you'll be sighing, want you out again. Dear Ken.
Tom Carey and Ian Lillicrap, isn't that great? Well done, boys. That is brilliant. There is the long version. There is the 12-inch that people... I'll put it up on my social medias. Good luck, Ken. It's not going to be the same without you, says Sean in Welling. Richie, I think Sean in Welling is welling up.
Yes.
Ken Bruce was the voice of my childhood, along with Sir Terry. Feels like the end of an era today. Lots of love to him, says Perry. Ken, you will be missed so greatly on Radio 2. I have made everyone listen to Popmaster. Good luck. From Paula, and I think it seems fitting that we finish our show. There were so many messages, I wish we could have read them all. But your voices and some pretty good impressions of our dear Ken, it's over to the listeners.
My five-word we Ken is thanks for all the memories.
Wishing you beautiful things, Ken.
My five words are no reason for kettle anymore.
Ah, good morning, Zoe. I'd just like to wish Ken Bruce all the best in his future endeavours, and I'm just going to say I'm going to miss him at 10:30 and Popmaster.
You've been asking for five words regarding Ken this morning, but I've only got two for him. No, not them two. It is a thank you.
Good luck, Ken, and goodbye. We'll miss you very, very much.
Oh, yes. We all love Ken Bruce, and we're going to miss him. But I thought he was going to carry on till 2024. But I was 1 year out.
Five words. I've grown up with you.
Our five words for we Ken are wonderful, energetic, knowledgeable, entertaining, nice. Spelling, we Ken.
But all the best, my mate.
For the five-word we Ken, I would like to say, Ken, I'm gonna miss you.
Oh, they were amazing. Weren't they brilliant? Well done, everyone.
Yes.
And incredible wonderful impressions. And here he is, our radio friend. I'm hoping, Ken, that you have steadied yourself for today's show because it could get emotional.
Well, I wobble about quite a lot anyway. So, I'm leaning on the desk as usual. Yeah, that was absolutely lovely. How kind.
No, you are very loved, my darling, and you'll be greatly missed by us. Shall we hear it for Ken? Enjoy your last show, darling.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I will miss you. I will miss you.
Live on the BBC Sounds app. BBC Radio 2.
Lots of lovely music on this programme. Don't go looking for any secret messages or hidden agendas behind them. They're just good songs. All the way through. Enjoy. There are the Jacksons. As I said, the music today is just good stuff. Don't listen expecting hidden agendas or secret messages. We just want to play lovely music and a normal programme. Very, very normal. Nigel Harman will be choosing the last two tracks of his years. We've got Gorillaz, Album of the Week, Cracker Island, and Depeche Mode with Ghosts Again, the Record of the Week. And of course, we'll have our last edition here of Popmaster. All of that on its way. Tim from Penkridge. Well, people are sending lovely, kind messages, as you would think. My five words are, can I have your chair as the wheel has just broken off mine at work? If I can get out the front door with it, it's yours. Need a big bag, though. She can sing. It's Pink and Trustful. 21 minutes to 10, Friday the 3rd of March. I was quietly dozing, driving down the M4. Hey, steady. Gareth from Swansea. Keep your wits about you. I was driving down the M4 on my gas tanker this morning. Well, look, be careful. Don't own up to that. Don't let people be able to follow you around. Could be in for another Brinks man. A gas tanker? You're worth a fortune. Anyway, I heard a familiar Scottish voice on the radio and my first thought was I'd drifted off for an hour and ended up in Cardiff. But no, I realised it was only 8:25 and you were, in fact, Ken, on the Today programme on Radio 4. So my then thought was, well, it's either one of two things. He's gone into politics or what's he been accused of this time? Thanks for your confidence in me. Thank you. I'm glad you came down with a second. I'm sure of that. While the bugs annoy, they sing. Well, the other people have put the BBC air conditioning in. Very cool indeed. It's Wham and Club Tropicana. Thank you, says Andy the Limestone Cowboy, for mentioning my name over the years. Well, thank you, Andy. He says, I fully understand that at your age, one long record after Popmaster simply isn't enough. You now need a job which gives you a long break after every three records. Continuing our policy of only playing fantastic music today, OMD, Orchestral Manoeuvres in the Dark, Pandora's Box.
Gospel music has the power to move you, to lift the spirit, soothe the soul, raise the roof, and get you on your feet.
Misha Paris.
Such a tune. Come on, people, let's get busy. Dance with me. Bringing you together with some of my gospel gems. I'm exploring our gospel music travelled out from the church and into our playlist and pop charts.
This is Misha's Gospel Gold.
Oh my gosh, so uplifting!
Listen to the full series now on BBC Sounds.
Here he is, it's Richie Anderson. Good morning,
good
sir.
Good morning, Ken Bruce.
Look at you, looking a picture again.
Thank you, I've made an effort for you.
Well, it looks
today.
The same as you were wearing yesterday, but still, it's lovely. But
I've had a shower.
Oh! Thank God for that. Right, what have you got for me?
Busy in Ayr, the Ayr bypass, the A77, the southbound side, is queuing because they've closed two lanes at the Whitlitz roundabout, and queues for that one about to the Sandyford Toll roundabout. So it's affecting traffic heading towards Maybole. The M62 eastbound got a lane out on the exit slip road at 31 for Castleford because of a breakdown in Boston in Lincolnshire. Sleaford Road, the A52, is closed and slow because of a burst water main between between Brothertoft Road and Colton Road. Hendon in London Church Road, the A504 queuing because of an accident earlier on between Brent Street and Ravenhurst Avenue. The M4 eastbound got a lane out on the exit slip road at 4 for Heathrow because of a broken down car. M3 north, one lane out between 3 and 2 because of a breakdown. And on the M20 westbound, a lane out on the exit slip road at 9 for Ashford. That's because of an accident. Traffic not coping too badly there, and you are fully up to date.
Right, we are. Rick in Preston has written to say, looking forward to Popmaster this morning. I've got my abacus ready to double check the scores. Call it Radio VAR. That's rude, I think.
I know.
You know, a man makes one mistake in 150 years. Well, one mistake in one programme. Well, actually, one mistake in one Popmaster. And you get traduced for it for the rest of your life. It's honestly, it's a disgrace. Anyway, you'd think I was counting up your scores the way they're going. Because I'm always right with that.
Yes, you are.
This is the record of the week. It's Depeche Mode. Ghosts Again. Depeche Mode, new single. It's called Ghosts Again. It's the record of the week. Durham Dave has kindly written to say, on this momentous day, here at the Shotley Bridge Shed Appreciation Society, we have awarded you the honourable position of Golden Shed for your outstanding contribution to broadcasting. Also, the Snod's Edge, Whippet and Chihuahua Racing Club awarded you the Golden Tail. I'm sure these will not be your only surprises today. You're so right, but these will be the very greatest of them. Put your loving hand out, baby. And I'll wag my golden tail. I'm begging. Yeah. Time box and begging. Now that you're officially on gardening leave, says Sheila, could you pop up to A's Garth in Wensleydale and sort our garden out? The builders have been in, they've left the place in our right mess. Though I'm sorry, I've only got a few weeks. If I had 6 years, I might be able to get my own garden done, so now. Jamie Goddard says, I was just wondering, your BBC pass, you won't be needing it any longer, will you? So I need a new ice scraper for my windscreen. If you're looking for perfection in a record, you may just have found it. Marvin Gaye, Heard It Through the Grapevine. Beautiful. Later, we've got Gorillaz, Cracker Island, the album of the week, and we'll be hearing the tracks of his years, chosen by award-winning theatre actor and star of TV shows, including EastEnders. And now, on Casualty as Dr. Max Christie, it's Nigel Harmon. They'll be Popmaster as well. Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 10 o'clock. This is Catherine Cracknell. The BBC understands some energy companies are expecting the government to extend its package of financial support.
Listen live on the BBC Sounds app.
Take that with Giants. Funny thing is, none of them are very tall. It's Friday the 3rd of March 2023. Good morning. It's 7 minutes past 10. Thank you. Just before I go any further, thank you so much for all the lovely messages, lovely kind messages, and lovely, beautiful cards. So many cards. Festooned. The studio is festooned in cards. Really, really kind of you. And here's another of those lovely messages from Tony, who says, I actually live on the street you grew up on in Glasgow. Whoa, that's great. Now that you're leaving, I'm going to stick a blue plaque up there on your old house stating, Ken Bruce lived here. Don't worry, he's now left. Niall Horan, his new single, it's called Heaven. 11 minutes past 10 now. I'm just wondering, writes Phil Vowles, will today be a special giveaway day? Are you having a clearance sale of favourite memorabilia? If so, I'm putting in bids now for a Ken Bruce cafetiere, a box of shortbread, and particularly a Radio 2 inflatable chair. Yes, all of these massive prizes were at one time or another given away by this programme. The cafetieres, I'm afraid to say, well, they all smashed, really. I mean, cheap glass, that's what you get. The shortbread, well, we've got lots of that left. However, it is now sort of, it's slightly desiccated. It'd be very useful for spreading on a dance floor if you wanted to just increase the grip a little bit, but otherwise, no. And the inflatable chairs, well, they've all gone. The inflatable chairs all went. What we didn't send out are 2,500 foot pumps for them. So if you want one of those, there's a warehouse in Wapping. Such a good song. It's the Cardigans and Love Fool. Well, it's now 10:15, so we'll do our love song for today. My gorgeous husband, John Alderson, give him a mention, please. 50. Well, actually, they've been together 50 years today. He was in the army when we met on Christmas Eve, 1971. Got engaged in Mallorca, 72. Married 8 months later. We have lived in Germany, Holland and Cyprus over the years. Now live in County Durham. You shouldn't have told them the last one. The bailiffs might find you now. I love him very much, says Christine, and would do it all over again, even though our eyesight and bones would not agree. We have two sons, Paul and James, wives Ruth and Zoe, four beautiful grandchildren, Bethany, Joshua, Sullivan and Scarlett. Wonderful people. Love song from my lovely mum, Margaret Rose, whose birthday it is today. Lots of love from Nicola, James, Simon and Jane. She'll be enjoying a few days away with my dad, Chris, but I'm sure she'd love to hear a birthday wish. Yeah, when they get back, probably. Love song to celebrate my son, Sam, reaching the age of 20 tomorrow. He is a true gent, a little like somebody else I know. Oh, you're not talking about me, sorry. Vince and Lisa Haycox, this is in Anglesey. Looking forward to taking him on a cruise to the Norwegian fjords to celebrate, buying matching deck shoes to look the part, and plenty of travel pills. Oh, yes, yes, you might need those. Julie Atherton Hall, it's her birthday today. She's my wife, says Wes of Devizes. Well, I used to know a rhyme about you. Devizes. She is 68, but very young at heart. She loves crafting, interior design and cooking. Lucky old Wes. Play a song for our 25th wedding anniversary today, says Janet, along with Andrew, the Staceys of Pontefract, West Yorkshire. We met 39 years ago. We've been together every day since then. Two lovely boys, Matthew and Oliver, and their partners, Jess and Eva. Off to Harrogate for the night. Whoa! Sin City, eh? Wish my sister Nicola... excuse me. It's just as well I'm stopping today. I might not last till Saturday. Wish Nicola a happy birthday for today, says Jennifer. Our whole family listens to the show every day from right across the world. Keith and I are in Norway, Evelyn's in the UK, and Ronald and my fiancé Arthur, brother Ronald and my fiancé Arthur, are in Australia. Blimey, O'Reilly. Do you not get on? Sis McConkey, 100 years of age today she is. Born and raised in Belfast, lived all over the world with her husband George. She now lives in the New Forest. She has a great memory, can tell us what outfit she was wearing to an event many years ago. Well, I can do that because I always wear the same thing. Sally says, we're going out for brunch with the whole family this morning. Then the afternoon, a party, some live music, an afternoon tea. God, they live down there in the New Forest, don't they? Love song for my fantastic husband, Tim Doolan, on his 50th birthday. This is Charlie. A loving and wonderful man. Makes me laugh every day, even with his clothes on. My daughters, Debbie, Lynn and Claire, want to say hello to Mum and Dad, Ray and Jean Castle, celebrating their 56th wedding anniversary tomorrow, travelling down to Hailing Island for a long weekend and seeing David Essex. Well, do you live down there? That's nice. Looking forward to this hugely. First holiday away for quite a while. Some good old sea air. That'll do them a world of good. Love from the whole family. And finally, Paul Wolfe is our son, says Anne Wolfe, on behalf of Mum and Dad and all the family. 40 he is today. Wish him, please, a happy birthday. A great son. We'd like to thank him for all he does for us. Working from home. We hope he has a lovely break on the Isle of Skye with his girlfriend Katerina and hope they get to see the Northern Lights. Oh, well, yes, the Isle of Skye is the perfect place to see the Northern Lights, provided there's no cloud cover, of course. So, June the 21st, I think. 88 to 91. Must have been cheap wine if you can remember it. That's Chris White and Spanish Wine. Lovely song. Good old love song. Don't forget, Steve Wright is here on Sunday with two whole hours of love songs from 9 a.m. You'll be listening, Richie, won't you?
Of course I will.
Yes, you will. And we'll listen to you in a moment or two. Be a nice,
well,
little,
yeah.
Be a nice little change, won't it? Yeah.
Over the last few weeks, you may have noticed a few things across the BBC going missing, such as a cloak from The Traitors.
Let the mind games begin.
And Julia's onesie from Motherland.
It's ridiculous.
But all for a very good cause, because as part of Red Nose Day this year, you could win some of the BBC's most iconic items.
Put your hands where I can see them. What's going on?
Ah, yeah, we got Luther's coat too. Sorry, Luther. To enter, find out more or donate to Comic Relief, go to bbc.co.uk/rednoseday. We'll find the terms and conditions and privacy notice. You must be 18 or over to enter. The giveaway closes at 11:59 p.m. on Saturday, 18th of March, 2023. Good luck.
Richie, we are ready for your travel.
Thank you so much. We're going to start in air, the air bypass. The A77 is queuing. They've closed two lanes at Whitlitz roundabout with queues at the moment back to Sandyford Toll roundabout. So it's affecting the traffic, heading towards Maybole. The M65 westbound, this is just in, blocked between 8 for Accrington and 7 because of a police incident in Boston in Lincolnshire. Sleaford Road, the A52, is closed because of a burst water main between Brothertoft Road and Colton Road. In Hendon in London, Church Road, the A504 queuing because of an accident earlier on between Brent Street and Ravenhurst Avenue. The M25 clockwise got a lane out on the entry slip road at 28 for Brentwood because of a broken down car. The M4 eastbound got a lane out on the exit slip road at 4 for Heathrow. That's because of a broken down car. The M3 north, one lane out between 3 and 2 because of a breakdown. On the M20 westbound, a lane out on the exit slip road because of an accident at 9 for Ashford. And I'll have more the other side of Potmaster. But now is the time, as always, to brew with Bruce.
You're so right. Right again, Reggie. Sean in Buxton, you know, people are sending in nice things, but some people are not sending particularly nice things today. Don't forget, Ken, to sew some kippers into the lining of the studio curtains when you go. Oh, that's not a very nice
No, don't
thing
do
to
that.
Do you think I would do a thing like that in this studio? I'll do it in Richie's office instead. You know. Podmaster coming after this. It's the wonderful Jesse Ware. Good, good new single from Jessie Ware called Pearls. She sang it in the Radio 2 piano room just a couple of weeks ago. And, of course, she's been sitting in for Joe Wiley on Radio 2 all this week. You can still catch those on BBC Sounds. But now... time for Popmaster, and Anna Page is here first from Hastings. Good morning, Anna.
Hi, hi. I'm so pleased I made it just about for your final show.
you've made it on here. Well done, and so have I. So that's good. We're both here together. A little bit about yourself, Anna. What do you do?
I'm a singer-songwriter, and I'm also a music teacher, and I also do a bit of painting and writing. And I'm, I say my album, I'm an independent artist, is on Bandcamp, Stars and Rockets, if anyone wants to help me clear my spare room of all the copies that are currently, I haven't promoted it very much, but it's my
You're promoting it now, that's for sure. So, well,
that's okay. So,
you're a multi-talented artist, I think we can take from all that. And music teaching, how's that going? Are the youngsters still up for it?
Yes, I teach all ages from about, I've taught a two-year-old and a 93-year-old, so I cover the whole range. I teach singing, guitar, ukulele, piano and songwriting. So it's a big range.
Oh, yeah, certainly is.
Not as anyone else, hopefully.
Brilliant. Oh, that's lovely. Well, now, look at this. We've got to ask you a couple of questions. First of them, about bonus questions, so you must choose one of these. So the topics today are either instrumentals or it's only words. Instrumentals or it's only words.
I'd go for it's only words.
Right.
Well, that's a good one for me.
There are your bonus questions for today, so we have those. What do you think your score will get to today? What does it normally do?
Well, I got 36 last Friday, which I think emboldened me to do this, but usually 18 would be happy.
Right, okay.
If
you've done a 36 before, you can do it again, no doubt about it. So we wish you, Anna, the very best of luck. And
thank you.
Here they come. In 1975, the Carpenters had a top three hit called Please, Mr... What?
Postman.
Is right. 3 points. The song Everybody's Changing was the top five single in 2004 for which group? Everybody's Changing.
Is it Travis?
It's not Travis, I'm afraid. Oh. No, it's actually Keane. Keane.
Oh, yeah.
Now, here's your first bonus question. It's only words. You're about to hear a 1968 hit by the Bee Gees that was successfully revived in 1996 by which boy band?
It's only words, and words are all I have to take your heart away.
That That's the Bee Gees. Which boy band revived that in 96?
Was it Take That?
It was not. I'm afraid it wasn't Take That. It was actually Boyzone. Boyzone.
Okay, not good on Boyzone.
In which year did these three songs all reach the top 10? Don't Want to Lose You by Gloria Estefan, Americanos by Holly Johnson, and If You Don't Know Me By Now by Simply Red.
Gonna guess 86.
Yeah, a little bit. 89. 3 years away. 89 it was.
Not doing great then.
Okay.
Oh, well.
But thinking of 1986, released in that year, the German duo Modern Talking had their only top 40 hit in the UK with which song? Modern Talking.
Not heard of that, so it's a Crash and Burn Day. Not good.
Oh, it's Brother Louis. Brother Louis was the title. Okay, here comes your next bonus question. It's only words. This is a top 10 hit duet from 1978. Please name either of the two vocalists. Eva. Either of the two vocalists on that, please.
I really like that song. Is it, I'm just going to have a wild guess, is it, I can't even think of anyone.
No? No, not hovering, right. Okay, we'll tell you. It's Scott Fitzgerald and Yvonne Keeley. Of course, used in the film Babe quite a lot. Right.
Which
1995 hit song by U2 featured on the film soundtrack of Batman Forever?
Is it The Fly?
No, I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. It was Hold Me, Thrill Me, Kiss Me, Kill Me. That one.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Yeah.
Never miss
not
a.
Doing really well.
No, okay. There's plenty.
On my qualifying questions.
There's plenty of questions left. Don't worry. There's three more. Never Miss a Beat was the title of a 2008 top five song by which group? Never Miss a Beat.
2008.
That's right.
Black Eyed Peas.
Bad luck. No. Kaiser Chiefs. Kaiser Chiefs.
Okay.
Here's a bonus question, last of those. It's only words. Listen to part of a top 20 hit from 2006, and then please name the group. This is a land of a thousand words, but it seems so few are worth the breath to say. Who's that? Which group?
No, I'm just doing really badly. I can't believe I'm the music.
Well, it's Sizzle Sisters. Sizzle Sisters, of course.
Oh, yeah.
Jake Shears was in the piano room just last week. Right. Final question. Which 1978 top 10 song by Dan Hartman was a top 10 cover for Yell in 1990? Dan Hartman in 78, Yell in 1990. Which song?
No, can you get more than this? Honest.
Well, it was instant replay. Instant replay.
Oh, bless. So, at least it didn't work out.
You got your first one right, Anna, so there you are. That's something.
That's so funny. There we are. I think it's maybe instrumental. Who knows?
Well, wait and see if they get chosen. You might do better on those in the second round. However, 3 points is your score, and I won't say it's been a winning score before, but, you know, you never know what could happen. So, let's see.
You never know.
Right. It's going to be our next contestant, who is Paul Hurst from Norfolk. He'll be here after this. That's a piercing one, isn't it, that note? Bebop Deluxe, Ships in the Night. And this time, here's Paul Hurst from Norwich. Hello, Paul.
Hello, Ken. Hi.
Are you all right?
Yeah, not too bad, thanks. I'm terrified, very excited, and I'm just privileged to be on the last show, on the last Master.
You are amazing. the last contestant on Pop Master on Radio 2, so there we are.
I can't believe it.
Well, let's see if we can make it a memorable one. First of all, though, tell me about yourself. What do you do?
Well, I'm Paul. I am from near Norwich. I work for Norfolk County Council. I support for schools. I'm a huge music fan. I love going to live concerts. I saw Suzanne Vega last week in Cambridge, and Suede coming up at the weekend. So two of your piano room guests. So that's really exciting.
Yeah, they were both fabulous to have. You know, and indeed everybody on piano room was. But they were just, they're so good when they're singing live. And surprisingly, people as experienced and as talented as that, they were all just a little bit nervous when they were doing it. So it's great to see that they still get that kind of little frisson before they perform. Great stuff.
Yeah, it's an amazing sound with the orchestra. It's beautiful.
It was amazing. And you'll love the gigs that you go to see.
I can't wait.
Well, let's look at your bonus questions. Instrumentals, that one, or something beginning with X, EX in this case. Something beginning with EX or instrumentals.
It's going to have to be something beginning with X, I think.
You're not going to chance the instrumentals.
I've had some scary instrumental rhymes before in the past, so I'm going to leave
that's
that.
True. Well, we'll never know now. We'll never know. No, it's consigned to history. So, something beginning with EX we're going for. We wish you, Paul, the very best of luck, and here they come. Man on the Moon was the title of a 1992 hit for which group?
R.E.M.
R.E.M. is right. The song, Somebody Else's Guy, was the 1984 debut top 40 hit for Jocelyn who?
Brown.
Brown, that's right. Jocelyn Brown. Bonus question. Something beginning with E.X. Going to play you a 1960 hit by Cliff Richard, which was also featured in a movie in which he starred. Can you name the film?
And though there was no one, nobody to see, a voice in the wilderness brought comfort to me.
Cliff, in 1960, featured in a film in which he starred. What was the title of the film?
All I can think of is Summer Holiday, I'm afraid.
No, it's Espresso Bongo. Espresso Bongo. Right. In which year did this week's top three have Blockbuster by The Sweet at number 3, Part of the Union by The Straubs at number 2, and Come On Feel the Noise by Slade at number 1?
1973.
That's it. Exactly right. That's the year. 1973.
Year.
Well done. The songs Strong Enough, All or Nothing, and Dove L'Amore were all hits in 1999 for which singer? Strong Enough. All or Nothing.
Cher.
Cher, it was Cher. Well picked up, yes. Brilliant. Right, bonus question now. Something beginning with EX. You're about to hear the first top 40 entry by this group. Can you name them?
Baby, you're so excitable. I don't care if you get me into trouble. Baby, you're so excitable. Won't you share some excitement?
Name the group, please.
Amazulu.
It is Amazulu. Excitable. Lovely. 29 Palms was a hit in 1993 for one of the UK's most acclaimed singers. Who is he? 29 Palms.
5, 4, 3. Sting, is it?
No, it's not Sting. No, it's Robert Plant.
Oh, yeah.
Celine Dion and Peebo Bryson had a top 10 duet in 1992 with which song? Celine and Peebo.
It's not Beauty and the Beast, is it?
Beauty and the Beast it is, yes. Oh, you're getting these. You're pulling them out from dark corners of your memory. They're coming from. Right, OK, well done. Bonus question, something beginning with EX. This was a top 20 hit and the title track to their album by a highly successful Jamaican group. Can you name them? Name the group, please.
Is it Bob Marley and the Wailers?
Bob Marley and the Wailers, it is. One more question. Who made her only top 40 appearance in 1976 with the song Here I Go Again? Here I Go Again, 76.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
No, I'm afraid I don't know.
That was Twiggy. Twiggy had that. Yeah, very good song too. Right, 27 points for you there, Paul. Well done.
Very happy with that. Yeah, thanks.
That is a great score. Well done, 27 points. You know your stuff. So, we'll be testing you on more knowledge in a minute or two for 3 and 10, so just wait for that. But in the meantime, we have to say, sorry, Anna, farewell to you now.
That's fine. Definitely outclassed there. I did better on his round, but still not as well as him. So brilliant. Well done
thanks.
To him. And
thanks
good luck in 3 and 10. Yeah, I normally do better than 3. But anyway, I'm just pleased. I feel like I've won just being on this show today. And the T-shirt is fabulous. I kind of wanted that anyway.
Right. Well, that's good. It's coming your way. And you do, of course, get your traditional 30 seconds of shout-outs anytime from now.
Thanks. Yeah, just to dedicate this to the memory of my lovely mum, Gillian, who always had Radio 2 on in the kitchen. My dad will be 91 in July. My sister and family, the Braithwaites. My brother, who's moving house today in Santiago, Chile. Julia, Everett and John. All my magical musical friends. Anyone who knows me. And especially thanks to you, Ken, for being such a warm and funny friend to the nation and being the soundtrack of our lives for the last however many years. 40-odd years.
Very, very kind of you. Thank you so much, Anna. We'll send off your T-shirt and hope.
Oh, could I have a signed photo as well?
We've still got one left. Yes, we'll do that for you.
Thank you. That's fine.
We'll do that. Anna, lovely to talk to you today. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you very much and good luck in 3 and 10.
Thank you. All the best now. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Anna Page of Hastings. So, it's Paul Hurst of Norwich. Paul, are you ready for 3 and 10?
Just about.
Come on, we can do this. So today, please, the titles of 3 UK single chart hits. 4.
3 in 10.
Duran Duran.
Have you to a kill, the reflex, is there something I should know?
You're going to ask for me, but you got them, yes. Wow.
Woo!
Well done.
Thanks.
3 just
sort
like that. Yeah. You do know your stuff really, don't you? If you know that much. Yeah, is there something I should know? The Reflex, View to a Kill. They are all... Well, April 84, The Reflex. The other two were 85, but that... No, sorry. Yeah, there's something I should know was 83. So within a two-year band. Well done. 33 hits Duran Duran had, and 14 of them top tens. And you got 3 just like that. You're a worthy winner of our last smart speaker to go out the door. So congratulations, Paul.
Thank you very much.
Well done. Would you like to use the 30 seconds we offer?
I'll definitely give it a go.
On you go then.
So a big thank you and hello and lots of love to my dad, Christine and Mike, and my sister Jane. Hello to David, Rob, Jeff, Martin and James, everyone at ICT Solutions, everyone at NVIDIA Voices Choir, everyone who goes to Lollard's Quiz Night, Terry, Chris, Alex, Paul and Chris, all my wonderful university friends. I've had some amazing 50th celebrations this year. Ollie, Mike, Dean, MRH, MRL, Mike, Mick, Andy, Rachel, Vanessa, Dinadine, Juliet and Diana and all their families. Lots of love to everyone and anyone who knows me.
Brilliant stuff. That's great. Paul, a delight to talk to you today, and well done for scoring so well. All the very best to you.
Can I just say a big thank you as well? I know so many people around the country just love listening to you. So much wonderful company music, and even a few good jokes over the years. So big thank you, and good luck for the future.
Thank you very much. Not very many good jokes, but thank you very much indeed. That's very, very kind, Paul. Thank you. Well done, you. All the best now. Bye.
Thanks. Bye.
Paul Hurst. Two nice contestants there. And that's Popmaster for now. Thanks so much to the great Phil Swern, Dr. Pop himself, and to Neil and to Simon, who compile questions with Phil. And of course to our team here, the other Phil McGarvey and Janine Meyer-Smith, who make sure everything is absolutely right and ready to get to air. And we always have a good song after Popmaster. Today is no exception. Brilliant bit of work by Slade. Good old Noddy, what a singer. How does it feel? It's going to be the travel in a moment.
It goes a little something like this.
Mixing influences.
Well, hello, this is Fatboy Slim. I'm going to take you on a journey through the tunes that have influenced me and made me want to make music.
With Fatboy Slim.
These influences come from all over the place. Different countries, different decades, different styles. From soul, to hip-hop, reggae, disco, blues, funk, punk, pop and dance music.
Do you like good music?
It's impossible to condense it all for you, but let's try.
Mixing influences with Fatboy Slim.
As we wander down that musical memory lane with its different crossroads and T-junctions, listen now on BBC Sounds.
Here's the slim boy of travel. It's Richie.
Thank you. We're going to start in Kilmarnock. The A71 is closed on the westbound side because of emergency repairs. That's at the Moorfield roundabout. In Boston, in Lincolnshire, Sleaford Road is closed and busy because of a burst water main between Brother Toft Road and Colton Road. The M180, the eastbound side, one lane out at Junction 1. That's because of a car having one of its tyres changed. Humberston in Leicestershire, Humberston Road, the A47 closed and slow because of an accident between Forest Road and Percival Street. Tintwistle in Derbyshire, Woodhead Road, the A628 blocked and queuing because of an accident between Old Road and Crowdon. Burton-upon-Trent, Derby Street is closed and very slow for emergency repairs. That's where it meets Victoria Road. On the M20 westbound, there's a lane out on the exit slip road at Junction 9 for Ashford. And Ken, I cannot believe that that was the last Potmaster with you and I.
Yes.
Because there's been so many memorable moments. In fact, there was one person who was particularly memorable, and she's been in touch with the team and I, and she wondered if she could give you a message, if that's okay with you.
All right, hold on. I think I have some. Oh, play
yes,
me, Ken.
If you
right,
look,
okay.
That'll be the one.
Okay, right, here we go.
Hi, Ken. It's Char Doherty here, and I just thought I would fill you in on what has been happening since we last spoke when I proposed on Potmaster.
Say hi to my partner Matthew. I can't imagine not being with him, and I hope we're still together when we're as old and wrinkly as you are, Ken. And on that note, I want to say, Matthew, will you marry me?
Oh!
There's a Bluetooth speaker in it for you, Matthew, if you say yes.
Matthew and I got married in May last year, and we've had 10 months of absolute wedded bliss. Well, mostly wedded bliss. Well, sometimes wedded bliss since. We've since added a beautiful dog to the family, and I just want to say thank you for everything, for being such a big part of our love story, and maybe we'll see you at the 10-year wedding anniversary party. All the best and good luck for the future. Take care.
Oh, that's lovely. Dear Char, I remember that is one of the best moments we ever had on Potmaster, was it not, Richie?
Very special.
Absolutely brilliant. And so nice to hear that they're sort of pretty much getting on all right after all these years. I'm not sure I can wait till the 10-year anniversary, though. I mean, I missed out in the wedding reception. So the 10-year anniversary, oh, that's going to be trouble. Anyway, lovely to hear that again. A happy, happy memory of Potmaster. What was your score today, Richie, by the way?
39.
Some things never change. Jake Shears. Too much music. Still to come, the album of the week from Gorillaz and Nigel Harman choosing the tracks of his year. Stay tuned for that. All coming up in the next hour. Radio 2. Sounds app. Smart speaker. 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 11 o'clock. This is Catherine Cracknell. Labour's defended offering a job to the former civil servant Sue Gray, who led the investigation into lockdown parties in Downing Street. And that's the BBC News at coming up to 3 minutes past 11.
Listen live on the BBC Sounds app.
Brilliant. Mark Ronson, Bruno Mars, Uptown Funk. It's 7 minutes past 11, Friday the 3rd of March. Some lovely messages. Thank you. Thank you for them all. Much, much appreciated. I have no hope of being able to reply to everybody, but I hope you'll take this as a thank you. Thank you very much indeed. Franny from Ramsden Heath says, Ken, you're like my radio husband. When you talk, I'm always half listening. I go out and come back, and you're still talking. Special. Lizzo. Special. Hey. It's 10 past 11 now. We're just going to pause briefly to pay tribute to the late Wayne Shorter, who's died in Los Angeles at the age of 89. What a great saxophonist and a huge influence on particularly jazz in the second half of the 20th century. Played alongside many of the greats of that genre, Miles Davis, Herbie Hancock, Carlos Santana, Rolling Stones, he played alongside as well. The thing we're going to play now is a piece of music from a little bit later. He co-founded Weather Report, the jazz fusion band. So we're going to play that. This reached into mainstream music. A lot of people love this song. I'm playing it particularly because for a very short time, it was the theme tune to the pop quiz I presented on Radio 2, Pop Score, back in the late 80s and early 90s. And for one series, this was the theme. What a brilliant piece of music. Weather Report and Birdland and the late Wayne Shorter, who has died at the age of 89. What a contribution to music. And we've got plenty more great contributions coming up, like this from the Alan Parsons Project. The Alan Parsons Project with Eye in the Sky. It used to be the sort of thing they said about travel reporters, isn't it?
Yes.
And they used to send them up in a helicopter.
Yes, I remember that.
Right, yeah, yeah, the Eye in the Sky. Do you get sent anywhere for the travel reports?
No, I have an issue with heights.
Do you really? Yes, I thought I saw you on the stepladder looking a bit pale the other day. Yes. Here he is. Here's Richie.
Thank you. We're going to start in Kilmarnock on the A71. The westbound side is closed for emergency repairs at the Moorfield roundabout. That's on the B7064. In Boston, in Lincolnshire, Sleaford Road, the A52 is closed and busy because of a burst water main. That's between Brother Tuft Road and Colton Road. The A1M northbound, so this is North Yorkshire, one lane out because of a broken down van between 44 for York and 45. M6 South, one lane out between 27 and 26. Tintwistle in Derbyshire, Woodhead Pass, the A628. This is blocked at the moment and queuing. There's been an accident between Old Road and Crowdon. Humberston in Leicestershire, Humberston Road is closed both ways because of an accident between Forest Road and Percival Street. The M56 eastbound, one lane out at 14 because of a broken down lorry. The M20 westbound, the exit slip road is partially blocked at 4 for Label whilst they recover an accident, and also a lane out on the exit slip road at 9 for Ashford. That's because of an accident. Now, Ken.
Yes, yes.
I know you said earlier
There's more.
I know you said earlier on that Shah proposing was one of the best moments on the show, but there's been lots of best moments on the show. In fact, there's pretty much one every day. And I wanted to remind you and everyone else of one that might have been the best ever. So I know you'd have a surprise. If you look at your cart screen.
Play me Ken 2.
That's the one.
Okay, we'll give that a go.
Now listen, here's what I want to say to you, Lynn Bowles. You and I, over the years, we've had a... There's been a frisson, if you will, between us.
Yes.
And, I don't know, sometimes when that happens, between a man and a woman, the woman can sometimes be mistaken for things, I don't matter, but I'm not. And, Lynn Bowles,
what?
I want to say on air...
What?
I'm sitting on something big. And I want you to be my wife.
Well, the thing is, Ken, I think...
Before you answer, Lynn,
yes.
Will you have a look at this?
Oh, I'm definitely not marrying you now.
Hmm.
And that thing you're sitting on?
Yes.
That's the cushion I normally put out for you, dear.
Thank you very much. With a protective covering, very wise after the incident.
More than one.
Botmaster is on its way. Ken Bruce, BBC Radio 2. We're trending on Twitter, you know.
What's Twitter?
I don't know. I like how it feels, though.
Hi Ken, it's Rob Brydon, sending you my best wishes and congratulations as you start on this new chapter, and also to say thank you for letting me be you that day, that April Fool's Day some years ago, because it really was a lot of fun indeed, didn't I? Maybe get to do it again someday, I don't know. Potmaster.
Good old Robbie. Actually, I was talking to him just a few days ago, and he never mentioned a thing about this. And he said, I'm off to New Zealand. He's off to New Zealand to do his tour, New Zealand and Australia. And I thought, right, that's one less. That's somebody that won't be interrupting the programme on Friday. But I should have known better. Thank you, Rob, and I hope the tour goes well and people do turn out in their tens to see you. Thanks, Richie. Is that the end of the surprises now?
Maybe.
Oh, good. Thank you. The album of the week is Cracker Island by Gorillaz. That was the title track with Thundercat there. Since you're on gardening leave shortly, says this texter, will you now be appearing on Jeremy's show with Terry Walton on the allotment? Oh, that's a good idea. Yes, thank you, Andy in Yatton. I'll put my name forward. I'll ask him in just a couple of minutes. Darren in Hull says, I noticed Zoe was asking for five words about you today. Here are my five words. They finally found you out.
Pilot of the airwaves, here is my request.
Charlie Dore, she is a fantastic performer. If you can ever catch Charlie Dore in a live performance in a theatre near you, do it. Very, very good.
I love that. To me, is a classic.
So many good songs.
It's a classic Radio 2 song.
It is, Pilot of the Airwaves.
I love it. I play it the whole time.
I was a pilot here for years. I used to pilot over there. Pilot.
Listen, I don't want to say this is my last little conversation with you. I was totting it up. And
well, we will speak again sometime. I mean, I haven't blocked your calls.
You're free for lunch at some point.
I will be free for lunch at some point. We'll fix a date, yeah.
Because I was working it out. You and I talk for 3 minutes every day. It's quite rigorously patrolled by you.
Yeah.
And that means 15 minutes a week. So every 4 weeks we do an hour.
An hour.
So it's 10 hours a year.
Right.
And over 20 years, it's 200 hours. I haven't been paid.
No, 200 hours.
And you're just
I just sit
off.
Back and listen and go, right, fine, next. Yeah, that sort of thing. Yeah, you're saving the BBC a lot of money there. Well done.
You are.
How many hours did you say it was?
200 a year. Hours. No, 10 hours a year.
10 hours. Oh, 10 hours a year. Yeah.
Someone's getting away with it here, aren't they?
Man, somehow it feels longer.
Listen, my friend, I'm going to miss you so much. You're always ahead of me on every story. When we did the story of the letter that took 100 years to arrive, you kindly pointed out that we were actually covering it 2 weeks late. So,
I'm sorry. I don't mean to do that. But I see an open goal, you know.
Am I allowed to say I've worked with some great people and you're the best? I know you don't like praise. You're the most generous, intelligent, talented colleague. You are.
And we Scots, Glaswegians particularly, don't accept praise.
I know you don't, but for listeners need to know that for us at Radio 2, for the presenters, you are the Charlie Watts. Like, he's the drummer all drummers want to be like.
Well,
you're the presenter we all want to be like. He's got the smallest kit. I don't know whether that part of the analogy works.
Excuse me?
Charlie Watts.
We know each other well, but I don't think we knew each other that well.
And I've forgotten to tell you what's on the show today because it doesn't seem very important.
Right. No, look, give us a quick one.
Okay. Sue Gray did the investigation into lockdown gatherings and has now been offered a job as Sir Keir Starmer's chief of staff. Does that suggest the investigation into Boris Johnson, which actually cost him his job, really, was, in the words of Jacob Rees-Mogg today, a stitch-up by the left? There's also stuff about sales of seeds we must talk about because they're rocketing now that people are... You're going to miss all this, aren't you?
Yeah, yeah. This
I can see you.
Yeah.
I know, because your eyes lit up with the... Oh! Up by 20%. Are you somebody who's taken the seeds home and you think, I don't know what to do with them?
Right. Yeah.
Crackman in as well, who we haven't had him for a while. Actually, he's been a little while to going back. Do you remember this guy who was an expert in structural difficulties that you have in your house?
I remember you.
And he will diagnose, if you've got a crack in your hallway wall, let's say, he'll tell you which way the house is going to lean in 5 years' time. He's
very
brilliant.
Good.
Simon Pitchers.
Good, so come and examine your cracks.
Thank you. 31 years on mid-mornings, I think. I'm going to suggest you've got something in your cart wall we can play. I'm going to embarrass you further, right? You were doing stuff... Yes, I know.
Yeah, it's another one.
Well, your fantastic producer, Phil, he decided to find the best moments of our conversations.
So this is a very short extract.
They had someone on it for a week. They came up with nothing. So that's not what this is.
Oh, good.
Okay, you were doing stuff for Radio 2 since the early 80s. Your first regular show started in 1984.
That's right.
I think. So this is a Saturday show... Play it, Ken.
All right.
There he is, Russ Abbott. Vince Prince and the Tone Deaf. Atmosphere. Good record, huh? Great one. And I was watching Russ Abbott on television tonight. He was doing his See You, Jimmy, this Scottish bit he does. And he was making remarks about what Scots get up to at New Year. As we know, only a few days away, Hogmanay. He seemed to be implying that... people in Scotland drank a lot in New Year and got incapable and things like that. Well, I found that extremely offensive. Accurate, but offensive. I shall be completely sober much of the time.
Well, well, well.
40 years ago, you know.
Blimey. Yeah, yeah. That was the Saturday Late Show. Yeah, very nearly 40 years ago.
Well, listen, thank you. Thanks for being my friend. Thanks for being my colleague. Thanks for everything. We're going to miss you so much and it won't be the same without you.
Very, very kind. Here's Russ Abbott singing Atmosphere. No, it's Thea Gilmore. Thank you, Jeremy. I shall miss these chats immensely. Thank you. Thea Gilmore, what a wonderful singer. She speaks in colours, that is. New single. Time now, though, for The Tracks of My Years.
The Tracks of My Years. BBC Radio.
actor and director Nigel Harmon. EastEnders, you remember, but in his latest big role, he's just joined the cast of BBC One's Casualty as Dr. Max Christie. More about that soon. First of all, his second-to-last choice. It's Super Thriller.
As soon as I hear this song, my feet just start moving. It reminds me of James McAvoy. We did a play together in town. We used to live in the same road for a little while, not far from the old man's pub. And we used to go in and out on our bikes to do this play in town. And the people that wrote the music were Ben and Max Ringham to the play. And they are part of the band of Super Thriller. And they were doing a secret gig in the arches of London Bridge. I think, if memory serves, it was their farewell gig. They'd been together for about 5-10 years and they were just like, we're going to go and do something else. So me and James went to this gig and were just dancing under the vaults of London Bridge, drinking. And it was just one of those magical moments where we kind of unplugged because, you know, if we used to go and get a sandwich or something, especially James was really up there, famous-wise, and I was sort of clinging onto his shirt tails a bit, having been in EastEnders. So we just danced, we drank, we had a brilliant time. And Super Thriller and Ben and Max Ringham have been a part of my working life ever since then. We've done so many shows together. We've worked on a new musical together. So I've been trying now for 20 years to get them to reform and to play so I can hear this song again.
Right. This may be the pivotal moment where it happens. Definitely. Now, you were talking yesterday about returning to acting and, of course, you have joined the cast of Casualty now as Dr. Max Christie. Casualty is a juggernaut, isn't it? It just keeps going and going.
Yes, you jump onto the juggernaut doesn't pull over and let you get on. Yeah, it's an extraordinary beast. It's brilliant fun to do, but just walking on the set, you kind of go, wow, this thing's massive, because you can just walk anywhere. We can take a camera anywhere and we can shoot anywhere. So there's no fake walls. It's all pretty much a hospital. And it's been going for 37 years, I think, which I was staggered about. Yeah, it's good times.
And Dr. Max, can you describe the character?
Yeah, he is acts first, fill out the paperwork later kind of guy. He reacts with his heart sometimes more than his head. He's a really good leader. He's good with staff. He's good with his patients. But, you know, sometimes if the rules are going to get in the way, he'll break them and just, you know, march to the beat of his own drum. Yeah, he's a good man, but, you know, you've got to keep an eye on him.
Right, we will. Every Saturday night on BBC One. So, Nigel, your final choice is Bobby McFerrin. Don't worry, be happy.
I mean, this sounds a bit twee, but I love this song because it's a really good mantra for life. Whenever I hear that whistling at the beginning, and the do-do-do, it makes me cultivate that kind of happiness. In my other life, when I'm not acting, I'm a meditation practitioner and teacher. And if there was one thing I could teach, it would be to sort of let go of the anxiety and stress and the worry that sometimes we cultivate, and instead we should be happy and cultivate happiness. And one of the really easy ways to do it is to just listen to this song. And if you get the chance, stick on the video, because it's just three guys just messing about, one of which is Robin Williams. Yeah. But yeah, it's heavenly, this song, and I love it.
A pretty good guide to life, definitely. Nigel, thank you so much. Best of luck with Casualty, and thanks for choosing these tracks.
Thanks for having me.
There you are. Don't you feel better for that? Nigel Harmon's choice in the tracks of his year. Bobby McFerrin, don't worry, be happy. Take the advice, Richie.
I will, and we'll start in Kilmarnock on the A71. The westbound side is closed for emergency repairs at the Moorfield roundabout. In Boston, in Lincolnshire, Sleaford Road, the A52 is closed because of a burst water main. This has been closed since yesterday evening, actually, so it's between Brothertoft Road and Colton Road. In Humberston, in Leicestershire, Humberston Road, the A47 closed and slow because of an accident between Forest Road and Percival Street. In Gloucestershire, the M4 westbound, there's delays because of closed one lane between 20 and 21. In North London, Whetstone High Road is closed because of a police incident between Totteridge Lane and Chandos Avenue. So we've got queues back to St Margaret's Avenue behind the Waitrose, or the supermarkets are available. The M25 anti-clockwise, one lane out between 27 and 26 at Waltham Abbey because of a broken down van. On the clockwise side, one lane shut between 10 and 11 for Chertsey because of an earlier incident. And the M20 westbound found Elena on the exit slip road at Junction 9 for Ashford because of an accident. That is you fully up to date. And I just want to say, Ken, that working with you over the past 4 years has been a joy. The one thing that people always say to me is, what is Ken like in real life? And I always say, what you hear on the radio, the kindest, warmest, friendliest person.
And then you tell them the truth.
No. And if you look towards the door, the production team.
Oh, look. There you go. Oh, gifts. Oh, this is lovely. Thank you.
And we love you a lot.
Should I open this or just... It's a... It's always good on radio, brown paper, isn't it?
Yeah.
Sorry about this. I don't have the strength to open it. But... Take this out. Oh, and it's a lovely picture of all of us at the end of the Radio 2 piano room. Oh, yeah, the whole team, the orchestra, technical team, production team, everybody there. That's great. I had such fun doing that. And a lovely card. Thank you very much indeed. Yes. Shall I open this or... I won't be able to read it all. Oh, that's a rude word to use about me. I'm sorry. I mean, how dare you write that out? Oh, that's lovely. Thank you so much. That's really, really kind. I'm going to miss you all. Absolutely going to miss you all. And Richie, thank you so much. Well, there's a bag as well. A Radio 2 bag of goodies. Have I got... What's a T-shirt? I've at last got a T-shirt. Have I? What size is this? It's Richie size. No, I'll never get into that. Thanks, Richie. Thanks, everybody. I've had such fun, such a laugh, about which I'll say more in a moment or two. But first of all, here's Petula Clark. Richie, go well.
You too, Ken.
Petula Clark and my love. So I've come to my last link, as we say on radio. A lot of people would say, oh, write down a big speech and deliver it. No, that's not the sort of thing I do. I do... Really just want to say thank you to everybody who has contributed in any small way to this programme, particularly the listeners. I really couldn't do it without listeners who contribute and complete the dialogue. We talk to each other on a daily basis, and I hope maybe sometime in the future we may be able to continue doing that. Thank you particularly to the members of the Ken Bruce Appreciation Society, Preservation Society, I beg their pardon, who sent in a lovely bottle of a certain Irish cream liqueur. Which I did think about drinking after song 9 of the show today, but I thought I'd better just wait until now. That's very, very kind of you. And thanks to all who've sent any kind of message of congratulations or good riddance. I would just like to say thank you particularly to Phil McGarvey and Janine Meyer-Smith. There are two... The only two in the production team. What a fabulous pair they have been. And to the BBC, I've been here for a long time, and apart from the occasional vagary, it is still the finest broadcasting organisation in the world. I thought about the song to finish, and one that comes to an end, I thought, might be the end.
Once there was a way.
And in the end, the love you take is equal to the love you make. And I have loved being here with you. Thank you so much. And may we meet again somewhere. And right now, for the last time, it's 12 o'clock. Here's Jeremy.
Thank you, Ken, so much. Good afternoon, Friday afternoon. Jeremy Vine here, BBC Radio 2. Today, Sue Gray, who investigated Boris Johnson's lockdown parties, is apparently off to a job with Labour. Do you smell a rat? There are amazing figures on how many people are now on antidepressants. Officials want to bring people off them. Did you struggle when you stopped? After one, we got Radio 2's very own crack man, structural engineer Simon Pitchers, who's brilliant. He's in to talk about whether something's gone wrong with your house. You can call. And demand for vegetable seeds has rocketed in the wake of supermarket shortages. But did you open a packet and think, I don't know what to do with these? If so, we can help.
Listen live on the BBC Sounds app.
BBC Radio 2.
All that coming, but let's go to the newsroom first and hear the very latest from Catherine Cracknell.
Thanks, Jeremy. The Labour Party has defended the decision to offer. And finally, as you've just heard, Ken Bruce has presented his show on BBC Radio 2 for the last time. Ken joined the station in 1984 and has made his mid-morning show the most popular radio programme in the UK. Thanking listeners, Ken quoted his last song, Golden Slumbers by the Beatles, with the words, "And in the end, the love you take is equal to the love you make." All the best, Ken. That's BBC News. 4 minutes past 12.